You know, you've started Motown Records, you found the Jacksons, like, let alone every other, like, influential artist of the last 50 years, and your son, who's living off his $400 million trust fund, just like, I'm going to be a musician too. It's like, oh, really? Yeah. Cool. Yeah, yeah. Check out my demo.
Yeah. Hey, Dad, I've got a new lyric. Oh, yeah, what is it, son? Where the drank? I got to know. It's good. Good, mate. Yeah, keep trying. Keep going.
Heard it through the grapevine? That was me.
Yeah, go through those records I gave you.
And you know who else is going to be in the band with me? My nephew. Weird. Fucking weird.
Does anyone know? Anyway,
I saw Red Foo.
Red Fern.
At NAMM earlier this year.
Oops. Did you?
Chose not to go anywhere near him.
Mm. What was he? What
can
was
he actually sing? That's my question. Can he sing?
Well, I think they were just looking around.
No, I don't think he has any talent.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Hence the blue spandex.
Mm-hmm. And the glasses with no lenses.
No lenses, yeah.
Yeah.
And one sleeve.
So zany. He's so zany, this Red Foo. This song has 494 words.
So let's
get into them.
Can we maybe just do like gist? Like you just in parts. You don't even tell us the lyrics. You just give us the gist.
You know how they say repetition is the key to a hit. Well,
yeah.
Not
they found the key.
It's a skeleton key. Yeah. All right. The intro. All right. Hold on. It's pretty in-depth stuff. Ready? Party rock. Yeah. Woo. Let's go.
Hang on. Can you start again? Because that's too much for my brain to process right now.
What exactly is party rock?
I've got the answer here, according to Genius.
Oh, okay.
It's music that's made strictly for partying and dancing. It is not made to simply listen to during youth nights at church.
What the fuck?
So you don't ever listen to party rock unless you're going to dance and party.
Yeah. Yeah.
You wouldn't just put it on in the car.
That's probably why I've never listened to this willingly.
I thought it was similar to a worry rock. Like, you know those worry rocks?
What, no,
Green Day like, worry rock.
What's a worry rock?
You like you rub it and you worry, or something. I don't know.
That is worrying.
Yeah, I thought maybe they put the rock down. They just party around it.
I thought it was like a slang for crack.
Oh, party rock! Hey, we've got a rock. Yeah. Oh, well, let's party if you've got a rock. Now it's time to party.
Woo!
Yeah.
Let's go. Woo.
Let's go party because of the rock.
Yeah.
I thought it was maybe one of those rocks that gets charged from having sat at a party. Like you just chuck it on the bench when you get there and that just charges the electronics charge, you know, the vibe of the evening charges the rock and makes you feel good. Like when you put a rock out at night and the moon charges it. When you get home and you're heaps drunk and the room's spinning, you're like, oh, that's right. I've got my party rock in my back pocket. That'll help me.
It's a party
no
rock.
No deal, McCutcheon. That moon money's mine.
Like, it's a rock anthem, but there's no electric guitars. There's no real drums. No real bass.
Hang on, mate. There's real voice.
No. Yeah. And it's party rock, not rock and or roll.
Not rock party.
Yeah.
Or maybe there's meant to be a comma after party, and he's like, party, rock, and it's like talking about Dwayne the Rock Johnson.
Yeah.
Party, rock anthem.
Do you smell what the rock is cooking?
Just reminded me of that. No, money down.
Money down.
Can you imagine a rock
party? Anthem?
Party. Imagine a rock party.
Rock anthem.
I can imagine a rock party would be like kind of as exciting as a Tupperware party.
Oh, hi, Nathan. What rock did you bring to the party this evening?
What do you polish your rocks?
Yeah. What polishing compound do you guys use for your rocks?
I like that. I brought a sapphire. Well, get out.
Is sapphire okay?
No, it's not.
Janine already committed to bringing the sapphire, so it was her responsibility, but now you've ruined it by bringing your own sapphire.
Jesus Christ, they're minerals, Marie!
You fucking idiot!
God, we haven't even got past the intro.
Okay, all right. Here's the chorus, all right? Red Foo is in charge of this chorus. Party rockers in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we gon' make you lose your mind. Woo. Everybody just have a good time. Clap. Party rock is in the house tonight. Oh. Everybody just have a good time.
I can feel it, baby.
And we gon' make you lose your mind. Yeah.
Yeah.
We just want to see you shake that.
Yeah. That was a waste of time, wasn't it?
I don't want to spend too much time on this, but it really just seems like they went into like goodtimesonggenerator.com.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's big
like,
time.
It's
I just feel
have the
like.
Words good time, tonight, party,
house.
And then it just fills in the blanks.
It's like what's the mad libs of pop music. I just feel like, stop demanding that I have such good fucking time.
Yeah, leave it up to me. I'm an adult.
Like, let's see where we're going to go. You've only just started. You're demanding to have a good time. I don't know where you're going with this. I don't know if they're going to start sacrificing babies in the next section.
I mean, imagine if you show up at the party like, g'day, how are yous? Eh, good, how are you? No, I'm good. And someone just gets up and goes, everybody just have a good time. You'd be like, whoa. I mean, I probably
every instinct
will,
tells
but
me
like,
not to.
Like, you're being a little bit forceful about this. Like, just let me decide if it's a good
time.
It's
like a game of Quidditch. You know how in the start of Quidditch, she's like, I want a nice, clean game from all of you. Some old lady comes out from the closet at the party. She's like, all right, everyone's going to have a good time. We're going to make you lose your mind. Right? Clean, nice, clean game from all of you. By the way, especially when you shake that.
The end of everything, and they're going like, yeah, woo, clap. Clap. I can feel it, baby.
It's like Batman, like sound effect punches.
Yeah.
Yeah, woo, clap.
Yeah.
Wow. Dance.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, you're not going to have a good time if you've got the clap.
Nah. Unless you're trying to get out of a world war.
Like, replace that with another venereal disease. Everybody just have a good time. Herpes. Like, it's not going to...
It's very,
not going to have a good time.
Very likely that he got that after this.
Yeah. So Red Foo's kicked us off here with that chorus. Now he's going to give a little dummy, little pivot.
Let him
roll.
Do the heavy lifting.
But then he back passes to his nephew, Sky Blue.
Red Foo, Sky Blue.
Yeah,
fits the rhyming scheme.
There's something very uncomfortable about a uncle nephew combination as a band.
Mm.
Is that weird? Does anyone else find that weird?
Do you know that Bow Wow, like Lil Bow Wow?
It's like, yeah.
Remember his first song?
Yeah. Like Mike, good movie.
Pretty sure Snoop... no, song, not movie. I'm pretty sure Snoop Dogg's like in the film clip and on the song.
Yeah.
Is that and he calls like, him... Where My Dog's At?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, it's irate, the song, by the way. But anyway, he calls him nephew over and over, and I always
thought... Let me hear you say.
It actually was his nephew.
I don't think it is.
Turns out he calls a lot of people nephew.
Yeah.
That's my story.
Oh, we got some lyrics to get through. Let's.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So verse
Shut
one.
The fuck up,
Daniel. Sky Blue's got it. Here we go.
Sorry.
In the club, party rock. Looking for you, girl. She on my jock.
Oh!
Huh? Non-stop when we in the spot. Booty moving weight like she on the block. Woo. Where the drink? I gots to know. Tight jeans, tattoo, cause I'm rock and roll. Half black, half white, domino. Gaining money, Oprah dough. Yo, I'm running through these hoes like Drano.
Wow.
I got that devilish flow, rock and roll, no halo, we party rock. Fuck, that's a goddamn mouth mouthful of shit words. Yeah, that's the crew that I'm reppin'. I'm on the rise to the top, no lead in our Zeppelin. Hey.
Nice.
Oh, God.
Running through hose like Drano.
Does Drano clear out hoses? Is that what it
does? Yeah, it does. It's a clever line.
It really does.
It's a very clever line.
And I rate that line. Like, that checks out. It's a good one.
Yeah, yeah. If you need to clear your hose.
I don't know about hoses, Drano. Though. Like, drain.
Oh, well, look, a drain, a pipe. I'd imagine if your hose was blocked, Drano would work on it.
Mm. Well done.
Right, sorry.
That's a good one. That's a good. So this is the nephew?
Yeah, this is Sky Blue. He's an 11 years Red Foos junior nephew. Now, he says here that he's gaining money. He's getting like Oprah dough. Do you know what Oprah's worth? $2.5 billion. I don't think Sky Blue getting anywhere near Oprah dough. Oh, not for this.
I thought maybe it was he was at one of Oprah's shows where she's giving out money.
Free car.
You get a bill. You get a bill.
Gaining money. Oprah Day is like, I go to Oprah's show every week and make it a good living out of it.
I don't know. I'm just really stuck on the whole, like, who's the nephew? Sky Blue?
Okay, this is the bizarre thing, right? So I knew that they were uncle and nephew duo all along. I knew that because I thought that was weird. But for until today, years old, I thought it was the other way around. I thought Red Foo was the nephew. And the Sky Blue guy who looks like...
heaps older.
It looks heaps older and more disheveled. But he is actually... He's the younger nephew. Yeah.
Okay, so that raises my next point well then. You know, Red Foo's the uncle who's like, come on, guys, like, we're just going to have a real good time. Like, everything's going to be all right. We're just going to shake it.
Yeah.
Imagine your nephew just comes out with, I'm running through these hoes like Drano. Imagine your nephew saying that.
I know. And you've got to stand next to him on stage while you shuffle and fucking dance around like a fucking... dickhead, listening to your nephew talk about how he's slaying hoes.
Like, I don't even know if it's worse if that was your dad. Like, I feel like
if you would feel like it's sort of not my responsibility, but it sort of is.
Yeah, you've got to at least report it back to the parents.
Yeah. Yes.
Well, you've got to assume they've heard the song.
Look, I doubt
if I was his father, I would not want to hear that. No.
This is, it's the kind of thing where he's like, Red Foo's got this on the phone. He's like, you know that new sound you've been looking for? Listen to this.
Yeah. Imagine if they play it with a family and everyone hears like Red Foo's verse and they're like, oh, Red Foo, well done. Party rock, yeah.
I'm glad you've finally done something with your life after 46 years.
Yeah, and then I guess he's like, I got these hoes like Drano, they're like, Sky Blue.
Ah, Sky
Blue.
Why
can't you be more like Red Foo?
Red Foo's just out there having a good time.
He just wants to see you shake that.
Yeah, that's right. So there's a whole other chorus here. I'm not going to go through it again. It's the same shit. But at the end of it, we get, every day I'm shuffling, shake, shuffling, shuffling, shake. I honestly thought that these were two separate songs. I thought there was a song that was called I'm Shuffling.
Me too.
And this song.
Like, I
get is it... there?
No.
It's the same song.
Yeah,
same
it
song.
Stops abruptly and then it does this bit.
Right.
Like, you gotta hand it to him, like, that's a hook and a half. Like, every day I'm shuffling. Like, that is a hook, if I've ever heard
of it. You know what the shuffle is called?
It's the Melbourne Shuffle.
It is called the Melbourne Shuffle.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Made popular in the 80s in Melbourne's rave scene.
Melbourne.
Can you imagine how shit that rave would have been? Melbourne, Victoria.
Are you sure?
Melbourne in Melbourne.
Yeah.
Because there's a Melbourne in Florida. Make a lot more sense.
No.
No.
Well, would you fucking believe it? The Aussies are at it again.
well documented that Redfoo used to frequent Melbourne pubs in the 80s.
He was pretty old, isn't he?
He was in his 40s back then, so, you know, understandable.
Every day in the 80s, I was shuffling in Melbourne.
Okay, verse 2. Now we got to see what Redfoo has to say. Step up fast and be the first girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad, now stop. Hating is bad. One more shot for us, another round. Please fill up my cup, don't mess around. We just want to see you shake it now. Now you want to be, you're naked now.
This comes across as really desperate, like... Be the first girl to throw me this cash, like, please, please help me.
You're saying please a lot in here. Yeah, please fill up my cup. I just want to see you naked. Please.
Yeah, this is
I'm worth $400 million. My dad started Motown Records.
He's very influenced by fucking, what's his face? Sky Blue in this verse.
Sky Blue, yeah. I think he's trying to get on Sky Blue's level.
No, he's nowhere near it.
But he's an old man, and this is like an old man's version of running through hose. Like, Drano is just to be like, oh, I'll throw cash at her like she's a stripper. But I'm not actually saying she's a stripper, and hating is bad. You should never hate. And I'm thirsty, but I want to see you naked.
It's like he wanted to make a really, like, kid-friendly pop and rock song, and then Sky Blue's gone, well, I got some stuff about Drano I could put in there.
Yeah.
It's a bit of a dichotomy, isn't it?
Yeah, a little
bit. Refuse, like, oh, what, is it like an instructional song about how to use Drano on the common tap, or? Nah, mate, just through the fucking women. Oh, gosh, all right, cool, sounds good.
Has that,
so when
like,
you say hose, do you mean, how's it spelt?
Garden.
Okay.
Garden.
Sorry,
or
Sky Blue. I think you garden might be or you might be suffering from a bit of dyslexia there, because hose is spelled H O S E, not H O E.
Garden or street.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good question to ask.
Yeah,
corn, corn organization or wetting.
Please fill up my cup. Don't mess around. Yeah, he does sound thirsty, doesn't he? He's being polite, but then he's enforcing that politeness. I'm like, please fill up my cup. I've asked you nicely. Now that the responsibility is yours, please don't stuff this up. I need to drink now. I'm parched.
Yeah.
Was one of those guys that's like pretending to fill in and doing the shaky hand. Come on, man. Yeah. Fill it up.
Just fill it up. It's been the prick.
Fucking around.
It's like that video. You guys would have seen that video of the guy giving the kid the ice cream, and he keeps messing with him by turning the cone upside down and everything.
Oh no!
Oh,
I don't watch. I don't watch videos that like put kids through traumatic.
I don't watch videos.
We'll put it in the show notes.
We'll stop.
Ice cream video.
Okay, so we get to the bridge, and this is when Lauren Bennett comes into it.
I didn't know there was a female in this song.
It's did I.
I had no idea.
Lauren Loza.
It was a pleasant surprise, though.
Yeah, she steps up. So she says, get up, get down. Put your hands up to the sound. Get up, get down. Put your hands up to the sound. Get up, get down. Put your hands up to the sound. Woo! Put your hands up to the sound. Put your hands up to the sound. Let's go. Get up. Get up, 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 get up. Put your hands up to the sound, to the sound. Put your hands up, woo! Put your hands up, put your hands up, put your hands up.
Sounds like a transcript from like a...
What are we supposed to do?
It sounds like I'm about to be shot by
a
policeman.
A transcript from a bank robbery. Get up, get down.
Stop resisting, stop resisting.
That's crazy that you said that, Biff, because I was about to say like, the way Chipsy read that sounded like it was a situation where you've just committed a crime and one of your like posse is hurt and the police are coming. And you're not really telling them to get up, like in any other way other than forcefully, like get up, get up, get up, get up,
get up, get up, get up.
There's three ways you can interpret this.
Have to get up right now, like
the panic starting to set in.
Get up, get up, get up,
get up, get up, get up, get up. Put your hands up to the sound. To the sound.
Woo, 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 woo. Yeah, the police siren sound.
It just kind of reminds me of that, you know, that Mr. Bean movie, the first one, and he's like in the airport and he's got like the handgun. He's like pretending to have a gun, but it's his hand. He's like,
yeah, yeah,
put
yeah.
the weapon on the ground, sir. Put the weapon on the ground. Get up. And he's like, oh, it's just a handgun.
Oh, Mr. Bean.
So, we pretty much get another chorus here and then we get the outro. The outro is,
here we go.
Oh, 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 put your hands up. Oh, 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 I can feel it, baby. Oh, 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 put your hands up. Oh, 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 put your hands up. Shake that. Every day I'm shuffling. Put yo hands up. Put yo, yeah. Put yo, woo. Hands up. Put yo hands up. Put your hands up. Put your hands up. Put your hands up.
Clearly right, clocked out at this point in the song.
If you reverse, so the oh, 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 put your hands up. Oh, 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 I can feel it, baby. If you put those words the other way around and reverse it, it becomes a very, very
flip
raunchy,
it and reverse it.
Very raunchy Santa Claus.
Put your hands up. Ho, 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 ho.
Hands
I can feel it, baby. Ho, 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 ho. Oh, put your hands up. Ho, 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 ho. Shake that.
It's like Bevo's Santa Claus mate that he used to drive around.
He's like, ho, ho, Merry Christmas.
I'm surprised there isn't a Christmas bell. Remix of this song, actually, now that you mention it.
I know. I feel like Mr. President are the only people to cash in on the
Macarena, Christmas. Too. The Macarena had a Christmas version.
Did it?
And bloody Bob the Builder, didn't he? I think. Anyway. Oh.
Bob the Savior.
Karen Wee Christmas.
Yeah.
There's more you could do with that.
There is.
Save it for the Bob the Builder episode.
Yeah, that's right. Save that for that. Yeah. That's going to be a good one.
Once we've wrapped up the Willy Wonka version, then we can do that.
Yeah. I've got nothing to say about any of
nothing,
this
nothing
random there. Noises it's... and sounds.
It's dumb music for idiots.
Well, I mean, look, they're saying shake that. Like, what are they? They didn't really specify. Like, if you just yelled at someone, shake that. Like, if you actually did it, you wouldn't know what to shake.
How many babies have died, buddy, listening to this song?
Red Fruit shows up. Shake that. The mum's like, all right.
He's wearing glasses. He must know what he's talking about. Fuck, they're not fuck. Real.
Shake that. Shake that. I've already shaked it. Shake it again.
Shake it.
I did want to say, name dropping Led Zeppelin in this is like definitely standing on the shoulders of giants here.
There's a bit it's where they're talking about Lennon and something else.
It's got a very fucking Fleetwood sort of vibe about it.
In the lyrics I've got...
In what way, Chibs?
Well, they don't call it Fleetwood Mac.
They don't say Fleetwood. Led Zeppelin.
Oh, right,
they
right.
Say,
I
like,
thought you meant the song sounded a bit like...
No, no, no.
No. No.
The, I remember really our like, references here and there. I don't know about you.
Yeah, sorry.
In the lyrics I've got, it says, on the rise to the top, no, like the Led Zeppelin line, it says, no lead, no lead.
In our Zeppelin. They actually, Led Zeppelin actually took the A out of lead so it wouldn't confuse Americans.
Oh. Really?
Yeah, that's why it's what? LED Led Zeppelin.
Oh, I why would it confuse the Americans?
Because they'd, think it, to a different they'd place. Think it would be lead Zeppelin.
That's, yeah, well, that's my point. It confused me. I'm like, no... No lead in our Zeppelin.
Well, that's why they did it.
Well, thank you, John Lennon.
That's
once again.
If he doesn't want it, hang on. If he doesn't want it to be like lead Zeppelin, then making it Led Zeppelin is saying the same thing.
Yeah.
Because if you led something, then you have been leading it. But lead, as in a metal, is lead, is spelled L-E-A-D. So, like,
yeah,
he's actually
but it's also pronounced lead. They've taken all the confusion out of it for you.
No, they've just over-complicated it, mate. For fuck's sake.
You don't want to confuse them.
Fuck Led Zeppelin.
Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. There's too much for the American audiences, so they called it the Sorcerer's Stone.
Philosopher?
Yeah, that was too much for the American audiences, so they changed it.
Wow.
Okay. How dumb do they think they are?
Philosopher is still a word. That's what I've always been.
It's a word. About.
It's a word in America. Like, no, it does not exist. You know?
Apparently. Maybe in some subsets of America, it does not exist.
Derek Zoolander got it wrong when he tried to say it. He's like, no, he's a philosophizer. So maybe that's why.
Maybe. This song was written by GoonRock and Redfu. Now, does GoonRock not sound like someone who is friends with someone called Redfu?
He's part of the gang, isn't he?
Yeah, he's well and truly part of the gang.
Who that? Also... Hey, Redfu! Oh, GoonRock! Hey, Redfu!
We've also got Listen B.
Who?
Listen B, apparently.
That's him.
That's GoonRock.
Okay, yeah, you're right.
GoonRock's real name is David Jamal Listen B.
Okay.
Yeah.
Listen B.
And,
yeah, it's like someone's halfway through saying his name and then someone's interrupted. He's like, and David GoonRock, wait, what is it? David Jamal, hey, Listen B, I told you to shut up. Anyway, as I was saying, David...
Redfu, real name Stephen Kendall Gordy, and Sky Blue, real name Skylar Gordy.
That's Barry Gordy is the Motown guy.
Yeah, that's him. And his net worth is $400 million.
Wow!
So Redfu's dad's worth $400 mil. And some other guy. There's a mystery dude, Peter Schroeder the Third. This guy has no presence on the internet other than a Twitter account that has 200 followers. And all he tweets about is hanging out with Sky Blue. Like, drinking with Sky Blue tonight. I'm out at the club with Sky Blue to his no followers. Like, I have more followers on Twitter than this guy does. But for some reason, he's a songwriter on this.
But to be fair, you post about Sky Blue way more than he does, though.
Well, I also say that I'm hanging out with Scott Blue at clubs in Miami. That's how I came across Peter Schroeder, because I'm like, hey, this guy's stealing my material. So I don't know if he's just Sky Blue's mate, and he was in the studio when they were knocking this out, but writing credits.
Do you think they were in the studio, though, or do you think they were on their laptops?
They were on their... By studio, I mean... the mansion in which Redfoo's dad bought him to live in. Yeah.
That's what I thought you meant.
I actually did read a thing that they... So Redfoo's best friend is Will.i.am from Black Eyed Peas.
Oh, yeah.
And
Black Eyed Peas in the same pod, if you ask me.
Yeah.
Very good.
It's good. So,
well done, Brian. Well done.
Will.i.am.
Listen, B.
Will.i.am introduced him to the head of Interscope, Jimmy
Irvine,
who gave him the green light to sign to Will.i.am's section of Interscope, which is just called Will.i.am Music. So it's kind of his label under the Interscope umbrella. So his best friend signs him. His dad's founded fucking Motown Records. The whole thing is like 100% who you know. The A&R dude from Will.i.am Music was like, we call this turnkey signing because their demos were good enough to release. So they didn't do anything. They just released the demos. But to say saying that, like, they've obviously got, you know, access to the best shit to be able to record or whatever. But it does just sound like it's done with, you know, Reason on a MacBook. But
it's not
nothing. Yeah. There's nothing amazing about it. It's all done. Yeah, it's done with a MIDI controller and a laptop.
Yeah.
Which I do love that, though. I love that something can be that simple and be a huge hit.
That's it. So Turnkey signing, they released the demos. They don't have to put anything into it. And that's obviously why old mate Jimmy's just been like, yeah, fucking just knock that shit out.
Mm.
It's already done.
Mm.
Yeah. So GoonRock, going back to GoonRock, looked into him a bit. He's made beats for Dr. Dre, Kanye, and he's written songs for Jennifer Lopez. So he's got a little bit of pedigree, old GoonRock.
Good on him, hey? Well done to GoonRock. Good on
him. So apparently LMFAO's original name was Sexy Dudes.
Yes. Oh,
that's so and good.
And they changed it to LMFAO after telling Sky Blue's grandmother, I guess, Red Foo's
mum,
yeah, that they were going to call the Sexy Dudes. And she was like, no. No, don't do that.
I love it. How was Sexy Dudes not
out loud, and that's where they got the idea.
How was Sexy Dudes not already taken, though?
I don't know. Well, you know, they probably just pay $50 million for whoever owns it, just so they can have it.
Sexy Dudes, I love that.
Here's a funny thing about Red Foo, right? He tried to make it as a pro tennis player.
Wow.
He attempted to qualify for the 2013 US Open as a wild card entry. And entered the USTA Northern California sectional qualifying tournament in June of 2013.
Wow.
But was knocked out 6-1, 6-2 in his first match. Does this not scream of like trust fund kid? Of like, I really think I can cut it. Yeah, like, I can cut it as a tennis player. I'm telling you, Dad, just please get like Agassi to coach me. And he's like, all right, fuck, just as long as you don't come and talk to me anymore.
Can't imagine any ideas.
No worries. And then they've got the best coaches, the best everything. They built like pro court for him. And he's like, fuck yeah, look, I can't get ranked anywhere in the world, but I'm going to go wild card entry. How the fuck does he even get a spot to play in a wild card entry without having a dad that's worth $400 million.
All right, he looks kind of fit. Like he might, he's a pretty good tennis player.
Come on. So, I thought that was pretty funny for Red Foo. How's this? They performed with Madonna at the Super Bowl halftime show.
What do they sing?
Why?
During Madonna's halftime show, they come out and do this midway through Madonna's set.
Madonna would have probably hated that.
Bizarre move, I think
she wouldn't have had a say in the proceedings.
But that is a weird move. This, again, you know what this screams of? Hey, Madonna, how would you like $10 million?
She's like,
will you let my son come out and sing a song at the Super Bowl?
Yeah.
Yes, I enjoy $10 million. Thank you.
She's like, that material girl money is long gone. So, yes, thank you.
Or it probably more went down like, hey, Madonna, I know you're performing at the Super Bowl halftime, but also we're probably going to get LMFAO out for a couple of seconds. And she'd go, yeah, whatever.
Yeah.
cool, guys. Yep.
Yeah.
And then she gets reminded before she walks on stage. Don't forget these dudes. And she's like, "What? Whatever. Okay.
All right. Yeah. I'm just saying, cash got exchanged for that appearance. 100%. Yeah. Everything about these guys just screams, rich kid.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It's hard. It's hard to like this for me.
Yeah. It is everything. It's everything you hate about the music industry, Bevo.
Oh, 100%. There's just that. Yeah. There's no whistling, but it's close.
I think there is some sort of synthesizer in there that sounds like a whistle.
Yeah. It's just I'll get to that when we get to rate it. But
well, anyway, the production of it. Look, it does sound like a demo. The vocals sound demo quality.
They actually do. I was listening to
There's no clarity to them.
I did listen to an isolated vocal track of it, and you can hear the auto-tune. But I was I feel like he might be able to sing, but he might have just been a bit off or whatever. But it's just real, they would have just used real cheapish mics, I think. it's all very shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. It almost sounds like they were recorded with their Max internal mic.
Yeah. Yeah. Like me on the podcast sometimes.
Yeah. Like Zav for about 28 of the 55 episodes that we've done. Yeah.
Oh, I say sometimes, but it's definitely more than half. All right. Sorry.
Yeah, that's the only note I've got for production. Like, it's easy to make everything else sound good when it's just MIDI-based stuff. Mm. But the vocals sound horrible.
I just think his whole career is just a bit of like a fucking, just a bit of a joke. Like, he kind of did this, and then his next, like, thing that he's done is, like, be a host on, like, talent shows.
Well, look at even the titles of the other songs of his. Sorry for Party Rocking, Let's Get Ridiculous. Yeah. Yeah, that's all I got.
Yeah. I actually highly doubt that he goes and parties as much as he says he does. I don't think he's even... I think he's one of those lame kids that got bullied in school who, like, just pretends
to be a party animal.
What did you do the weekend? I partied.
Prove me wrong.
Boy, did I party.
Come onto this podcast and prove me wrong.
Redfoo, what did you get up to on the weekend, bud? Did I party? I partied. Did ya? What'd you get up to? More of a party and like just heaps of
just rocking and partying, you know, party rock, heaps rock parties.
I just typed in Redfoo court case just to see if there was anything. Redfoo Glasser pleads not guilty. The man accused of glassing X-Factor Judge Redfoo has pleaded not guilty, as his lawyer told the court that the case was based on statements, and it goes on. So apparently someone hit him with a glass.
Someone glassed him and then pleaded not guilty. It's like, look, a glass did end up on his head. But
he got
look
a
at
good
him.
Behavior bond, yeah. So good on him.
Look at him. Look at him. Like, how can I be guilty?
Yeah, like, he was wearing lenses with no glasses in him, so I just thought to myself, he probably needs a bit of glass.
Oh, your glass has fallen out of your spectacles.
Yeah, your glass has fallen out of the frame. Here's a bit more glass. Gah, crack.
It's like the old Greg Bird passing his girlfriend a glass of wine, glassing.
Don't you reckon, like, anyone that ends up on what's he on, X Factor or The Voice? Or
I thought I vaguely remembered him being a judge on something. But
he was definitely on X Factor, but he just always in Australia, like, yo, I know talent so much because my dad was blah blah blah, and it's like, well, your dad knows talent then, not you. Like, fucking stop fucking pretending that you're the one that knows the fucking shit.
It always pisses me
talent
off.
Talent searching is not genetic.
One of the judges on one of those talent shows is like the least talented person in the room. It really gets my goat.
Do you reckon, like, anyone that ends up on those shows, something's gone wrong for them?
Yes.
Like, absolutely. It's just everyone on those shows, like, as we said, like, Danny Minogue, like, well, she's no Kylie. And, like, Redfoo, well, he's no... Sorry, what's his dad's name?
He's no his dad.
Do you remember the when one of the Jonas Brothers was a judge on something for a little bit when their career was in the shitter?
Well, like, I know you say no Sebastian bashing, but I think it's the ultimate irony that the first guy to win the first Australian Idol is now...
No Sebastian bashing on this podcast, please.
I'm not bashing him.
Ryan, disclaimer, no Sebastian bashing.
It's just a little ironic that he is now...
No Sebastian bashing, please.
Guy.
I want to test this out. You know what? Guy Sebastian is a mother. You know what pisses me off? Guy motherfucker.
Guy Pierce.
I was going to say Guy Pierce. I was going to say Guy at the bus stop, actually.
Guy Thierry.
Guy at the bus stop. Always
there. No Thierry bashing either. Yeah.
For that, everyone. Sorry to break your speakers at home.
No Sebastian bashing. Bevo, tell me about this video, mate.
Yeah, right, hit it.
Here's the video facts from A to Z, and they're coming at you straight from Ryan B. It's a terrible song, and I know you agree. It's the music video summary
with Bevo.
All right, okay, here we go. After a party rocking induced coma, Red Foo and Sky Blue enter a post-apocalyptic world where people can't help but dance in the streets. It is implied that industry and order has been eschewed in favor of dancing like a twit. There's also a robot for some reason.
Look, I have next to no notes about this. I couldn't even find who directed it.
It's dumb. Dumb music with a dumb video. So apparently
they've just tried to copy the 28 Days Later franchise, but just used a generic set somewhere of New York.
And the car they're hiding behind, a Hyundai Santa Fe.
They basically it's just a dance. It's just a dancing. It's like TikTok before TikTok.
Basically, the main thing I wanted to talk about is like they've set up this universe where no one's getting anything done because they're all zombie-like party rocking all the time.
Yeah, too much partying. Yeah.
And like I want to talk about what kind of world that would be where like no, like all the cars have crashed and there's the bonnets open. Like the cars haven't collided, they've just stopped and opened their bonnets and
yes. Yeah, that's true.
There's actually no sign of any car crashes.
They walk out and this old mate stops him and says, "Everyone's party rocking," but he's in like a business suit.
Yeah.
Like if the world's gone to shit, you're not wearing a suit and tie, like a shirt and tie.
Well, someone's got to. You'd want something. Someone has to.
Nah, you want something fairly comfortable. You could do a lot of running in, fighting in.
Mm.
Suits probably not the best way to go.
Sorry, did you just say something comfortable to do a lot of running in and fighting in?
Hmm.
How about a fucking jacket that only has one sleeve?
Perfect.
That's fucking comfy, isn't it?
Perfect. The only note I made about this was that Jesus dances center circle.
Yeah, there is one. Yeah. He gets in there.
Jesus. So Jesus has come back as well to get in on the shuffling.
Is it just me as well, or did this sort of spark a bit of a really shitty fashion trend?
Did it?
Yeah, like the t-shirts with the big font, like the Helvetica font, like the meme font.
When did it come out? Like 2010 or something?
2011.
Okay.
That was a shit
leopard
time.
Leopard print and
shit, real weird.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of a lot of the fashion in this, I must say. So I'll bow out of this conversation. You guys keep going. I've got clothes that look a lot like this, but anyway, let's move on to 4:53.
That's a long time.
Sounds really good because the rest of it is real shit. So
just jump into 4:53 with me, if you will. You'll see a man.
Oh yeah.
All right, now I reckon this is a one take thing. This guy has done this gigantic, like it's quite impressive when you see it. But basically, he's done this gigantic, awesome dance move, and he flips into the air. He looks like 6 foot in the air, and he lands directly on his upper back. Like, now I don't care how good of a dancer you are. Like, there's no way to make that be a dance move. He absolutely just ruptured a vertebrae.
But
don't
forget, at the very same time, a confetti gun goes off in the background. It's perfectly timed.
Yeah. Well, I don't know what to make of it. Like, I look at it, I'm like, that's a one-take thing. He's like, bang, and then they've moved on, and they're like, awesome, let's do it again. And the guy's like, no, I'm a paraplegic now. So,
no, I'll never walk again.
And they're like, what do you mean? I thought that was your move. He's like, no, I meant to land on my legs.
Well, if I'm going to be honest, we don't actually see him again on his legs.
Yeah. every other scene, he's in
on
a wheelchair.
His knees. He's like on his knees or he's like closer to the ground.
Ever since I started dancing, it's been my dream to completely give my body to the art of dance. And I've been waiting for the perfect moment and project to do it to. And I feel that this was the project for me to give away my most important bodily functions as a dancer.
Yeah, mobility.
And I feel I've made the right choice. You may now take me to the hospital.
Dude, it is so, he's so high in the air, he lands directly on his back. Like, oh, I don't know how you're walking away from
but
that.
Straight after that, they show he's a very flexible man. So maybe he's rubber. And he's bounced back.
Nah, like legit Gumpy. Though, at 5:32, the robot has got the most incredible dance moves. Like, I've not seen a fucking
dancing robot
move like that for bloody years, man. I tell you.
For years. He's no C3PO.
He's like, literally, it's like he's just like, oh, I don't even know how to describe it, like floating. But like, so it's so good.
So much animal like print in this video.
Only good thing. It's only disgusting. He's like fucking so clean with his moves. I don't know. I want to know the robot personally.
I also wanted to talk about the bit in, it's around 4:11 when they introduce the girl. I forgot what her name is.
Lauren something.
It's very much like the other guys are like, look, we got a woman. Check it out. Check it out. They're like featuring
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Pointing.
You know how we were talking about smashing hoes and throwing money at chicks at naked? Well, we're not sexist because we let one on the set.
Let one.
Yeah, and here she is.
Lens flare.
She's
Lens flare, Lens flare.
Lauren Bennett is from the band GRL or Girl. They had that Growl? Ugly Heart song, you know, Ugly Heart. Ugh.
Yes.
Yeah. Where the whole thing, that's one we could do for sure. Oh. The entire thing is sung at one monotone note.
Yeah, I used to have to teach that one to primary school age kids because they loved it.
Yes.
So I heard that too much in my life.
Yeah. My daughter
also
loved it.
At 5:37, this is just a shout out to one of our friends, Sam Coles. There is a gentleman that looks exactly like Sam Coles in his music video.
Look, it wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't surprise me if that was Sam Coles.
Yeah, look, 5:37. There's a blonde woman on the right, almost to the very far right of the screen, and to her right, our left, is a gentleman that looks like Sam Coles.
If I know anything about Sam Coles, he does tons of crazy shit, but it's also sort of humble in that. He won't really tell you about it unless it just randomly comes up in a conversation. Like, it would be, I wouldn't be surprised to be like, yeah, fuck, man, this time I was on holidays in the States, hey, and just walking down the street, and these people are like, you want to be in a film clip? And he's like, fuck, yeah, all right, I'll do it. And this guy was afro, and he had glasses, and it was fucking crazy. It was a good time.
Yeah. That's all I remember. You'd be like, his necklace.
Fuck, man, you are in this. You were in this film clip.
He's like, am I?
Yeah. Yeah, that would be it. Yeah.
There's one little kid in the audience too, just one. He's just watching it all go down. Yeah, someone had to bring their kid along to the, the taping.
Bring your kid to work day.
Bring your kid to work day.
Well, that's how LMFAO got here, was fucking bring your kid to work day.
That's a good place to end it, I think.
That's a really good way to end the podcast.
Yeah.
I have one YouTube comment. Right.
Not everybody.
Oh, YouTube comment.
Anyone else got any? I'll go first. This one's by Gunry. 2011. Every day I'm shuffling. 2020. every day I'm suffering.
That is a bleak comment. He's like, well, I've got leukemia, so well, now every day I'm suffering. It's different. It's different than what it was before.
I used to shuffle, now I suffer.
Look at this. There's 342 replies. Including, cool man, another depression joke. And here we go again.
Fucking hell.
I like this.
Yeah, nah. I'm just going on the comments now. There's nothing good. Everyone's
time
like,
fly by. It's sad.
What do you got, Sav?
There's one from Gabriel Singawi Chromo. I don't know who that is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, Gabriel. Yeah.
Party rockers in.
Sorry.
That's it.
Sorry.
Oh, there's a few.
Party rock is in.
There's a few on the
Party rock
comment
is in.
Section.
Yeah. Some people just love pressing enter before they're ready.
Yeah.
Here it is. Oh, not bad. A few mistakes, but great work.
Not bad for a demo.
A few mistakes that made it into the final fucking version. Okay, the legacy. This is insanity.
Yeah.
The single went number one in Australia, Belgium, Brazil, Canada, Denmark, France, Germany, Iceland, Ireland, New Zealand, Switzerland, the UK, and the United States. It also reached the top five in Finland, Italy, Norway, Poland, and Sweden. It is the best-selling single of all time in Australia.
No. You're kidding me.
No.
Yeah.
Worldwide, it was the third best-selling digital single of 2011 with sales of 9.7 million copies. It is the third best-selling digital song in U.S. history. Party Rock Anthem is currently ranked Billboard's sixth most successful song of all time. It is currently one of the 70 most viewed videos on YouTube with over 1.8 billion views.
That is incredible, man.
What's the biggest selling single of US like all time Billboard thing? Do you know?
No, I don't know. But this is third.
Do you think like when this came out, maybe streaming services were pretty fresh at the time?
No, it's 2011.
I don't think we had Spotify yet.
No, but I mean, this is like just iTunes. This is, yeah, pretty much iTunes.
I can tell you what the best selling US single of all time is, Av, if you're keen to know.
Digital song?
I just found out. Worthy.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know. Candle in the Wind, 1997 is what I got.
Oh, that's not it.
What did you get?
I got Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas Is You.
Oh, okay.
Fuck, all right. Yeah, look, the video won the Best Video Award at the 7th Annual TRL
Really?
Awards. Yep.
It's not a good video.
Best video. Red Foo's worth 4 mil. Sky Blue's worth 1 mil.
Jeez.
You think they'd be worth a few more mil, like a few more residual mil.
That's an imbalance.
I think they had to pay back a lot of money to whoever.
They're worth a lot more mil before this song.
Yeah.
This song had a lot of overheads.
Yeah, a lot of overheads. Yeah. They were paying radio stations like 10K a spin. Yeah. Yeah. This is one of those, like, just put your money where your mouth is so your kids will shut the fuck up.
Here's 50 mil, Redfoo. Use it wisely.
Yeah. Oh,
boy, will I, Dad. You watch this.
I bought 7,000 pairs of sunglasses and I removed all of the glass.
Watch it.
I'm going to need another 20 mil.
It's my image.
Yeah. It's important, Dad. It's important.
What did you do with all the glass? Well, I threw it in the bin.
As long as you recycled it, that's fine.
All right, let's rate this shit.
Motherfuckers, this is it. Now it's time to rate this shit.
All right, fuck. How much Drano would you drink?
Drink.
Because 10, because I reckon 10 litres, you're dead.
How long do you reckon 10 litres would take? I reckon 10 litres of Drano, I reckon you've got probably...
In the one hand, you have a jar of Drano. Yeah. On the other hand, you listen to this song again.
Which one's worse?
I had a friend who, we had these, some sort of lantern type thing that took kerosene. And for some reason, there was kerosene in a 4X can. And I watched my friend skull a good portion. It wasn't all of it because he figured it out. But he had a fair bit before he realized. He skulled kerosene thinking it was a 4X.
That's bad.
Yeah, it was very bad, man. He was
Did he throw up a lot?
He tried to. Like, nothing was coming up. And he was punching walls like he was. His esophagus was on fire. Anyway, back to the song.
Cool. Okay, well, that's a one. That's what happens at a one. That's the best situation. Yeah. And 10, you die.
Well, he died. Yeah.
So. Yeah. Oh, okay.
So even if you choose one, you still die on this.
Rest in pieces.
Yeah, it was. He died from AIDS, not from the kerosene.
Yeah, I think it was fine after that.
Yeah. Bevo.
I don't know whether I just talk about this forever or just give it a score and move on, but I'm an introverted person. Like, I'm very introverted. I'm an introvert. My natural enemy is the extrovert. And this guy seems to be the ultimate extrovert. And as such, I hate him with every fiber of my being. I'm
what, Sky Blue or Red Foo?
Red Foo, Red Foo.
Right,
Sky
okay.
Blue can do whatever he wants. I don't
as far as I'm concerned, he's I.
Yeah. I wouldn't. Sky Blue means nothing to me.
I probably saw him on the street last week, and I had no idea. He looks like a guy. Fuck Red Foo. Fuck his leopard print fucking tights and his shitty glasses and his fucked up afro and his super famous dad who wrote "I Want You Back," which is the greatest song of all time. Fuck you, Red Foo. Here's the thing.
What's going on? Felt like more of an attack on Red Foo than the song.
Yeah, it did. Yeah. It's a little bit personal.
Probably a really nice guy, but I don't know. This song annoys me a lot.
Look, I reckon there's a few people that actually get in touch when we release one of these episodes. Got a feeling Red Foo's not got a lot going on. We might hear from him.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Prove me wrong, Red Foo.
Yeah. Prove me wrong. Dan Southern.
Well, that makes a lot of sense, Bev. Everything you just said
I feel like Red Foo probably would have bullied me if we were in school together. Is all. That's
this isn't over. This isn't over between Bevo and Red Foo.
It's a deep hate. It's a very deep hate.
So you know, you can go back on your Facebook, like on this day. I'm 100% sure I wrote a status a couple of years back that was like list of people who can fuck off. And it was like Tracy Grimshaw and Red Foo.
No, it's
kids for Tracy.
Yeah, fair
that's
enough
great.
About Tracy.
Sorry.
No, Tracy. It's all right. No, look, it makes a lot of sense because you say like your natural enemy is an extrovert and all that. Like it explains why you hate me. yeah, I've always wondered, but now I know, so it's good. Bit of clarity.
And another thing.
I mentioned in another podcast we've done recently that me and my friend Brendan Young got a little thing going on where we're writing music.
Stop spruiking your fucking bullshit projects, mate.
I'm not going to do a full-on plug, but I'm saying it's...
Brendan Young really pissed me off when he used to try and like get up in my grill all the time, and that's exactly the attitude I've got towards Red Foo.
Very Red. He was acting very foo-ish.
Yeah.
So Bev hates Red Foo.
We've got some problems coming out of fucking this podcast tonight, I'll tell you.
It's therapy. Yeah. Therapy.
Long story short, projecting. Our music sounds like this. So I will give this a 3 because I think it's really funny and cool and good. Okay. And it's like,
fair enough.
It's like, it's so dumb. It's so dumb, but that's the point. It's the point is it's dumb. So I mean,
but Southern listens to it a lot.
I'm into it. I get into it. He's like, fucking. Where's she? Yeah, she's on my jock. I'm gonna say jock. Okay, you're an idiot, and I'm into that. I'm into being an idiot.
Yeah. Okay,
okay.
Zav,
real interesting from you both, actually. is it? I just want to ask a quick question. We've been doing this podcast for a while now, but I'm not entirely sure how things work still because I'm a bit of a loser. is 0 a possibility?
Ooh. Yeah, I gave 1 week a 0.
Okay.
I wouldn't for this song, but
gets a 0 from me because I love it.
Yeah.
Even better than
love
Coco Jumbo.
This song.
More than Coco Jumbo.
Oh dude, this song fucking is such a fucking tune,
I kind of
man.
Thought that about Zav. Like I'm thinking and now every time a song comes across, and this was a request by someone. Fuck, I really should write this shit down.
Shilly. I'm going to say Shilly.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. It was...
She requested a lot.
It was Red Foo.
Yo, do my song. Put another podcast into my song.
But when they come through and I see it in a message and I just think of Zav saying, you're in a club. 2 a.m.
Yes, dude.
Are you going to go home? Are you going to stay? And then this comes on. I'm staying for days.
Yes. It's like someone puts a fucking bag of cocaine on the table like, this is fucking free.
Every day I'm shuffling.
This is free. You can either fucking have this bag of coke or you can listen to this one song for fucking 4 minutes. I'm like, fuck, mate, I'm already so fucked. So I'm
the song goes for 6 minutes and 15 seconds, actually, according to
I choose
YouTube.
This song over a bag of coke. That's free. That's all I'm saying. That's all
wow,
I'm saying.
Good on ya. I'm proud of you, mate.
Because drugs are bad and coke.
Yeah, okay. A zero.
I think Red Crew's, I'm with Ryan, I think Red Crew's a fucking mong.
Oh, yeah.
But we're, but we're talking about the song.
Actually, not Red Crew. I know nothing about the guy. I've just decided based on this video that I don't like
it. Rate it. Highly rate it.
Yeah, yeah,
Tibbs.
Good on ya.
This song makes me experience neither highs or lows.
Don't be giving it a five. Don't you dare.
No fives, man. At least jump this side of the fence. Come on. You're welcome. Come on. Get
a dumb song for idiots.
Come on.
Yes.
Come on, Jizzy.
I'm the audience.
Come on.
I give it a five.
No.
Yeah.
Neither here nor there.
I don't give a fuck. I don't give a fuck.
Can we have a jingle
for
that?
If it's on, it's on. If it's not, fantastic.
He's on the fence. Neither here nor there. He's on the fence. If Dan wasn't in this one, it'd be a zero, a five, and a ten, which I guess averages out to a five.
Yeah, pretty much.
But yeah, stuck in, guys, because it's this side of the fence now. So
zero, zero, zero. Wow. That's, all right, make sure you...
let's never listen to this song again.
Well, you don't have to.
You don't. I will definitely go to bed.
None of us have to, really.
Well, you don't actually have to do anything ever.
Yeah, you're a free person.
Yeah. Make sure you follow, subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, Stitcher, wherever you get your podcasts, and tell your friends about it. Follow us on the social medias at 1001 Songs That Make You Want to Die on Instagram, at the 1001 Crew on TikTok and Twitter. And
that's it.
Go fuck yourself.
Every day I'm ring-a-ding-ding.
Ba-ba-ba-ba.